John Kalench speaks with the understanding voice of a decade of experience. He's been where you are, and he knows what works and what doesn't. On the street smart side, John knows the stuff inside and out. He's built a successful million-dollar multi-level marketing distributorship, created and directed his own network marketing corporation, and through his company, Millionaires in Motion, which he is the founder and president, has trained thousands of men and women to become successful network marketing masters. His style is personal, enjoyable, and fun to read. It's like having John as a close friend sitting in your living room, sharing his knowledge and experience so that you may learn. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight he's in your living room. Give him a Team Diamond, Nikian welcome for Mr. John Kalench!
I can't tell you how good it feels to be up here. Scary. This is the first time that I've been back on a platform since my little ordeal a few months ago. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I was first introduced to this glorious concept, method of doing business called network marketing or network distribution about 20 years ago. And as many of you are aware, that first night that I was presented this concept, went to a meeting, saw the circles on the board. I went home that night and I couldn't sleep. I set a goal that night because I was so attracted to this concept. I believed in it so much. I believed that I was going to be a part of it for the rest of my life. I wanted to set a goal that kept me really focused on what was important to me. And the goal that I set almost 20 years ago, that I've been working passionately towards ever since, is that by the time I die, I wanted to have 1 million friends. Well, I'll tell you. I set that goal because I not only saw the power of network marketing as to what it could do for me as far as my personal and financial goals, but that it also would allow me to express myself and to make a contribution. And that I saw the real value, the biggest asset that I could build in my network marketing pursuits was the quantity and the quality of the relationships that I created, the friendships. And so I kept very focused on that over these last 20 years. But I got to be honest with you. I really had no grasp as to the power of that goal that I set 20 years ago. I really didn't truly understand its power. It was only until a little over 2 months ago that I was diagnosed with this thing called pancreatic cancer. And the message got out to the community about my illness. Now, we didn't publish that message, it just got out. People started hearing about it, and they started telling other people about it. I guess that's how network marketing works. The next thing I know, I'm there, laying there in the hospital, and over the next few days and the next few weeks, myself and my family is just overwhelmed by the response that we've received from all over the world. Cards, the letters, the faxes, the gifts. My room in the hospital was so loaded with flowers that the nurses were afraid I couldn't breathe. It was absolutely unbelievable. And it really made me understand that because many of the responses that we received were from people that I never really met, that were just touched and moved by my books and my message and the difference that it made in their life. And I was just so taken by all of this that I couldn't help but want to thank each and every one of you, because many of those cards, many of those notes, many of those faxes and those gifts came from you, the NECAN people. Now I know that as you're out there in your daily routine and joy of building your business, that sometimes we lose sight of the kind of difference that we're trying to make in people's lives. We come from this pure space of enthusiasm and love and integrity for what it is we're trying to share with others, what we believe can help them impact and empower themselves for the better. And sometimes we run across people that are a little indifferent. Maybe some people are a little negative to what it is we're trying to share with them and how we're trying to contribute. Sometimes we take that a little personal. Sometimes we lose a little sight of what we're trying to do and whether or not what we're doing really is making a difference. Well, I just want you to know something, my friends, that in addition to the difference that you have made with your NECAN people and your groups, I want you to know that I'm a walking, talking, living, breathing, and giving example again of the difference that you made with myself and my family. I'm convinced it was your cards and your letters and your thoughts and your prayers that for a 48-hour period of time where my family wasn't sure I was going to be around, that you made the difference. And I want to thank you for the difference that you made in myself and my family. I only have an hour with you tonight. There's so much I want to say. I don't want this hour to be just spent on talking to you about the process that I've been through and my family's been through over the last couple of months. I didn't want it to be that way. I take a look at what you have done, your outpour of affection and acknowledgement and love for who I am and what I've done over these past few years of knowing you. I take a look at what you've done has given me a very special gift. And in return, I want to give you a gift tonight. I want to give you something that you can walk away with that can make an impact beyond anything you've ever experienced. I want to share with you a piece of information that I learned about 9 years ago that, without question, has made the biggest difference in my life. When I first heard it, I was attracted to it, and I hope by the end of my chat with you this evening that you are as attracted to it as I was. And there is nothing since that period of time, 9 years ago, that has allowed me to improve the quality of my life more than this thing called the cycle of success. For us to glean the wisdom of this thing called the cycle of success, we must have some kind of common definition for this word called success, because I believe each and every one of us are in this room because we are in pursuit of this thing called success. We might all have a different definition for it. We might all look for different things in order to experience it. But we're all in pursuit of this thing called a successful life. Some people have this belief, this perception that success is all about achieving some kind of goal, arriving at some kind of destination. Whereas the best definition I've ever been able to find for the word success was written by Earl Nightingale in both his book and in his film called The Strangest Secret. And he defines success as the progressive realization of one's worthy ideals. The progressive realization of one's worthy ideals. Now, when you truly understand that definition, you begin to understand that success is not about the destination. It's most importantly, like you have heard, about the journey. Success is all about how you feel about who you are and what it is you are doing every single day. Would it matter if a million people out there perceived you to be successful if within your own heart and within your own soul, within your own mind, you did not feel that success, you did not enjoy that success? It wouldn't matter what those million people thought. So success isn't anything that anyone can give you. Success isn't anything that anything can give you. Success is only a gift that you can give to yourself. Now, if it's true that success lies in the journey and not the destination, does it not make sense that we learn how to ride something through our journey, that we master it so that experiencing this thing called success every single day, every single moment of every single day becomes less and less of an effort? That the more we master this tool that we use to ride through our journey, the more it becomes effortless to experience this thing called success. So that's why we use the concept of this cycle of success. And if I can get the transparency up here for a moment, I'd like you to go back to that moment in time as a child when you first had your thought of wanting to have your own bike. It was pretty important to us, wasn't it? What was so important about that bike? What did it represent? What did it symbolize to us? Freedom. It was an instrument, it was a tool that would allow us to express ourselves in our own individuality and to become free, to go where we wanted to go, do the things we wanted to do. It was our first sign and symbol of being able to be free. And even though we weren't born with the ability, or born, I should say, with the experience of mastering how to ride it, we went through the process of learning what it is we needed to learn in order to master it. Because we knew that once we did learn how to ride that bike, we could go where we wanted to go. We could express our freedom. Many times in the process of trying to learn how to ride our bike, we would fall. We would get hurt. But we'd always stand right back up, brush ourselves off, and get right back on it. No matter how painful the experience, we kept getting right back on it until we mastered it. And then eventually, as we did that, we start to experience this thing called momentum in our life. That the hardest thing to do was to get the thing started. But once we got momentum and speed on our side, it was effortless. In fact, we even got so confident we took our hands off the handlebars a few times, didn't we? And our feet off the pedal. Because we had momentum, you see. We didn't totally understand what that meant as a child. But we had this thing called momentum and energy with us. The same thing with your cycle of success. Being able to master the tool that will allow you to ride through your life, through your journey, effortlessly, and to have momentum on your side. So with this cycle here, I'm going to share with you the different components that make up the cycle of success. There's actually six, one in the middle where the two pedals meet, and the five that evolve around it. Now, for the purposes of a better visual, so that you can follow me, I'm going to change the transparency now, so I can write on something here that has each one of these components. So as I talk about them, I'll just put them right in the proper place. So all you need to do is draw one circle in the middle and five around it. Are you familiar with how to do that? Let's take a look at the center circle. This is the hub. This is the center point upon which everything in your cycle of success evolves. There's nothing more important than this center point.